subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see everything about simplification. Okay, we are going to see from the basic formulae to the advanced level of prom, which will be appearing for competitive exams under aptitude. Okay, so now let's begin this video without any delay. And first, let's see what are the basic tricks which you need to learn before solving problems of simplification. Okay, these tricks will be helpful to save a lot of time. You can solve the same problem within very much less time using these tricks. Okay, so now let's see what are those tricks. For example, there is a problem 4 plus 44 plus 444 plus 4444 plus 444,044 plus 4. Okay, so this is the problem. Generally, if you need to solve this problem, approximately student will take more than half a minute or 1 minute. Okay. But here now we are going to discuss a trick which will help you to solve the same problem within less than 10 to 12 seconds. Now let's see what is that trick. Okay, first we need to count how many fours are there, how many numbers are there individually before plus. Okay, see here before plus there is 1 4. Okay, only 1 4 is there, so the count is 1. Here there are 2 4s, count is 2. Here there are 3 4s, count is 3. Here there are 4 4s, count is 4. Here there are 5 4s, count is 5. Here there are 6 4s, count is 6. Okay. Until here it's clear, right? So now the next step is, see in each and every value, the common term is 4, right? Common term is 4, okay? And what are the values which we found? We need to write it as it is in the braces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Here we did nothing. We just wrote what is the common term in all the numbers, which is 4. See, in every number we have 4. Okay. Every term here is made up of 4. So we wrote 4 separately. And in braces, we have written the terms which we have found out. Okay, here there is 1, 4, 1, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, 4. Okay, so the numbers which we have found out, we have written in a brace. And now we are just multiplying both the values. 4 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. When we multiply 4 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the answer will be 493824. See, this is the final answer. The sum of 4 plus 44 plus 444 plus 4444 plus 5 4s plus 6 4 is this. The ultimate answer is this, like this. See, using this trick, we have solved the same problem with very less effort by saving a lot of time. Okay, this is one of the trick which you must learn, you must know. And after this, the most important thing which one must know is rules of simplification. Okay, there are rules of simplification. Now let's see what are they. Okay, board mass. What is board mass? Now let's see what is board mass. Okay, first let's see what does board mass stands for. In board mass, B stands for braces, brackets. Okay, it is called braces or brackets. Brackets. We all know what are brackets. These are brackets, right? So in board mass, B stands for brackets. Okay. O stands for off. Off. Let's see what is off in the coming part of the video. D stands for division. We all know what is division, divided by. Okay. M stands for Multiplication. A stands for addition. M stands for multiplication. A stands for addition. And S stands for subtraction. Okay. Stands for subtraction. Okay, so when there is a problem and when that problem contains all these things, like if the problem has braces, that is brackets, if it has division, multiplication, addition, subtraction, in this sequence we need to start solving the problem. Okay, this is meant by Bodmer's rule. See, for an example, a problem has all these things. Okay, it has multiplication, division, addition, everything. First, we need to solve the problem using brackets and then of and then division, multiplication. In this sequence only, we need to solve the problem. Okay, so Bodmer's example. The problem is example 15 plus 24 into 26 Okay, so this is the given problem. 15 plus 24 into 26 divided by 2. This is the problem. Okay, so first see, this equation has all the symbols. It has braces, it has division, multiplication, everything, right? So in this sequence we need to solve this problem. First is braces. We should remove brackets. Brackets is also called as braces. Okay, so we have removed the braces. After braces, the next symbol is of. Of is also nothing but braces only. Like for example, if a number has another braces, it is called of. It is nothing but of. Okay, so here we have only one bracket, one set of bracket. So there is no O. There is O. There is no of. Of is nothing but, again, see, for example, if we have again other bracket here, it is called of. There is no O. Next is D. What is D? D stands for division. So now from this thing, we have to solve this problem using division method. Where is division? We have division here. 26 divided by 2. 26 divided by 2, which is nothing but division. Okay. Now we are solving division. Fifteen plus 24 into 26 divided by 2. This is the division. And after solving 26 divided by 2, we will be getting 13. Okay, clear till here. So even division we have solved. Now after division we have multiplication. So this is multiplication part. So solve this. 15 plus, solving this part, 24 into 13. 24 into 13, which is nothing but 312. Okay, even multiplication is done. So now addition, 15 plus 312, where the answer is 327. Okay, so even addition, we are done with addition. There is no subtraction in the problem, so we can just ignore it. Okay, so like this, in Bodmer sequence only, we need to solve the given problem. This video, we are going to see everything about simplification. So now let's start solving the problem. Here is the first question. A man has rupees 480 in denominations of 1 rupee note, 5 rupee note, and 10 rupees note. The number of notes in each denomination are equal. So, what are the total number of notes with the man is the question. Okay, so what does this question mean? A man, a person has 480 rupees it seems. Okay, totally the person has 480 rupees, and this is the total amount of the money with the man. Okay, He has 1 rupee note. And he has 1 rupee notes, 5 rupee notes, and 10 rupee notes. All these notes together made 480 rupees. Okay, so the person had 1 rupee notes with him, 5 rupee notes with him, and 10 rupee notes. And together, after counting all these three notes, he is having 480 rupees with him. Clear until here? Okay, so after this, the main thing is, what is he saying in the question? He is having the equal number of notes, it seems. See, he is having equal number of notes, it seems. Like he has some number of 1 rupee notes with him, he has same number of 5 rupee notes with him, and he has same number of 10 rupee notes with him. For he has same number of all the notes, okay? He have a few number of 1 rupee notes, few number of 5 rupee notes, and few number of 10 rupee notes, right? So all notes individually are same. Okay, let us think X. Okay, now let's solve this problem. So totally he has 3X with him. Okay, so the number of notes will be 3X, because let the 1 rupee notes be X, let the 5 rupee notes be X, and let the 10 rupee notes be X. The count of notes is X. Okay, totally it makes 3X. Clear till here? Now what is the next step? 1 rupee note. Let us think 1 rupee note is X. 5 rupee note, let us think as 5X. 10 rupee note, let us think as 10x. Okay, 5 rupee, 1 rupee note we are denoting as x, 5 rupee note we are denoting as 5x, 10 rupee note we are denoting as 10x, so that it will be easy for us to recognize what is 5x, 10x, and x. Okay, so when the man combines all the 1 rupee notes, 5 rupee notes, and 10 rupee notes, totally he has 480 rupees with him, right? Am I correct? He has 480 rupees with him. So now we need to find how many number of notes he has together, all together. Nothing we need to do, we just need to solve this equation and substitute in this 3x. Okay, so x plus 5x plus 10x, how much? X plus 5x plus 10x is 16x is equal to 480. X is equal to 480. When 16 goes to the right hand side, multiplication becomes division. So 16 goes to the new denominator and the x value will be 30. Okay, so now we got x is equal to 30. Now, what is the main question? He is asking us to find what is the total number of notes. Total number of notes we have denoted by 3x, right? Total number of notes is equal to 3x. X value is 30. So, totally 3 into 30 is 90. So totally the ultimate solution is 90. He has 90 notes together, in which 30 notes is 1 rupee note, 30 is 5 rupee note, and 30 is 10 rupee note. Okay, individually 30, 30, 30 all together is 90. Like this we need to solve this problem. Okay, this video we are going to see everything about simplification. Coming to next question, the price of 10 chairs is equal to price of 4 tables. The price of 15 tables and 2 chairs is 4,000 rupees. Then the question is, what is the price of 12 tables and 3 chairs? 3 chairs. Okay, so now let's see what is he saying. Okay, see, he's saying price of 10 chairs, price of 10 chairs is equal to price of 4 tables. Okay, price of 10 chairs is equal to price of 4 tables. Price of 15, price of 15 tables plus 2 chairs is equal to rupees 4000. And he is asking what is the price of 12 tables and 3 chairs. So this is the question. Okay. So now let's see how to solve this problem. So what is he saying now? He is saying price of 10 chairs is equal to price of 4 tables. Okay. Let's think. Let us think chairs as X and tables as Y. Okay, let us think chairs as X and tables as Y. Price of 10 chairs is equal to 4 tables. 10 chairs. Chairs we are denoting as X. So it is 10X and is equal to price of 4 tables. Tables we have denoted as Y. Okay, so 10x is equal to 4y. 10 chairs, price of 10 chairs is equal to 4 tables. Okay, so the same equation can also be written as y is equal to 10x by 4 we are sending to left hand side. It will become divided by 4. 2 5s are 10, 2 2s are 4. So 5x by 2. When we solve this equation, when we simplify this equation, it can also be written as y is equal to 5 by 2x. Okay, the same thing which we found, I'm writing here. To 4y can also be written as y is equal to 5 by 2x. Clear till here, right? After this, what they are saying, the price of 15 tables, the price of 15 tables and 2 chairs is 4000. 15 tables. Tables we have denoted as x and chairs we have denoted as y. So 15x plus 2y, total price of this is 4000 as given in the question. And now we are just substituting this in place of y. Now we already know the value of y. We are substituting 5 by 2x in place of y on solving this equation. 15x plus 2 into y, in y place we can write 5 by 2x is equal to 4000 after solving this equation. Okay, so cancel 2 and 2. 15x plus 5x is equal to 4000, which can also be written as 20x is equal to 4000. So x is equal to 4000 by 20, whose value will be 200. Okay, so now here we got the value of x, which is 200, right? So x is equal to 200. We got the value. So now in the question, what is he saying? What is the price of 12 tables and 3 chairs? Okay, so tables denoted by y. So 12y plus 3x. Tables is denoted by y. So 12y plus 3x. 3 chairs. Okay. So we need to find the price of 12 tables and 3 chairs. We know the value of y and we know the value of x. So we just need to substitute. Okay. So 12 into what is the value of y? 5 by 2x plus 3 into what is the value of x, 3 into x. X value is 200. So now we need to solve this. 2 ones are 2, 6 are 6, 5 are 30. 6, 5 are 30. 30x plus 3, 3 into 200 is 600. Okay. So 30x plus 600, and we already know the value of x. So 30 into x value is 200 plus 600. Okay. Again, 30 into 200 is 1000 plus 600. So it is 6600. So the value, the price of 12 tables and 3 chairs is 6600. Like this, we need to keep solving the problem. Okay, now let's see what is this question. If a minus b is equal to 3, a square plus b square is equal to 29, then what is the value of ab is the question. Okay, so they have given the value of a minus b, they have given value of a square plus b square, and now they are asking us to find the value of ab. Okay, so there is a formula for 2ab. 2ab is equal to, 2ab is equal to a square plus b square minus a minus b whole square. Okay, so this is the formula. Here we just need to substitute. 2ab is equal to, we know a square plus b square value, which is 29, minus what is value of a minus b? It is 3 whole square. 29 minus 3, 3 is 9. 29 minus 9 is 20. So left hand side as it is. So AB is equal to 20 divided by sending 2 into right hand side, which becomes by 2 divided by 2. 20 divided by 2 is 10. So the value of AB is 10. Okay, so like this, we need to solve the problem. So yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such wonderful videos. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.